Hello and welcome to Unplayable Trash, a War Machine and Hordes video channel from Australia. This game was recorded down in sunny Canberra at Wintercon, and is the semi-final of the Masters event, featuring Loud Chris Davies and Colin Bobliness Hill. My name is Tort, and I have here with me, Harry.
Hello.
Looking at lists, Colin Hill is running Asphyxius 3 and Scar 2. Colin has said that his Asphyxius 3 list is an all-comers list, while the Scar 2 list is designed specifically for Signa. Chris is running his usual Irusk 2 Fun Machine list and Butcher 3. So Harry, do you think there is any reason for Chris to drop his Butcher 3 list here?
Not really. It doesn't look like it's built to play into Crypt at all. I suppose when you've got that many press gangers, they can get in the way for a while, but Asphyxius is just going to carve them up with Carnage. He's going to get enough attacks and he's going to have enough recursion to push through.
Alright, so Colin Hill's list is Asphyxius 3, Ankleworms, Hyksos Raiders with Witch, Blood Witches with Hag, 2 units of Mechanical with Commanders, 2 units of Necro Surgeons and Thralls, Saxon Oric Dire Wraith, Hyksos Raider Captain and Ragman, and his objective is the Effigy of Dark. And Chris Davies' list is Irus 2 with a Bonded Juggernaut, Wardog, 2 units of Black Dragon Pikeman, Alexia and the Risen with Valachev, Widowmakers, Warder, Ayana and Holt, 2 Iron Fang Kovnik, Iris 2, and Gorman, and his objective is Bunker.
Groin cloth for you, Scarlock.
You gotta quote it. Alright, cool.
Groin cloth! Remember that.
Alright, so, I haven't even started deploying. Pikes are already coming off.
That's how it happens. Pikes off, groin cloth's off.
As I said, unless otherwise stated, my pikemen are directly facing you.
Sounds good.
Alright, so that's Chris on the right, and Colin Hill on the left.
Also, this can you please not excarnate Ayana and Holt before I
I'll try.
Black Beans?
You can also assume that they're facing, like, they're either the way that I put them or 180 degrees to it, depending on whether I fucked up, because their facing is weird.
Of course. Well, say if pikemen are required to face a certain direction, then I will face them that direction, even if they're charging.
Yeah.
Or if I really want this guy to face away, so I can make a pre-strike. Sneakily or something shit.
Who do you think's favored?
I actually have no idea in this case.
Hengos Bummings.
I would say Heroes 2 I think is favored in this matchup.
Why is
he's
that?
A really good quick strut with his feet. He's got Artifice of Deviation, which he's got Saxon Oric to deal with, but he's quite good. And while this list does have the Hag in it,
Heroes 2 has Airburst, so he should just be able to take out the Hag.
So, and also, I don't really know what this Asphyxius 3 is.
You might want to turn me down slightly.
And go. That's my idea.
Just have more dudes.
Gatsby? Gatsby's little friend. Saxon. Ragman. Gatsby's bigger friend. Mortar's range is 20, right?
20.
Like a boss.
You don't have Rengrave in this list, do you?
No, can't afford him. Saxon and Ragman instead.
Right.
Are you exactly symmetrical? Pretty fucking close. Mortars off to one side, slightly closer to your objective, and that's about it.
Yep. 2 units of pikes, they're both the same, so there's no difference there. Got Gorman near my caster.
2 fronts, so there's a friendly zone and an enemy zone. You gain 1 point for dominating your friendly zone, and the objective in your friendly zone is friendly to you, whereas the objective in the enemy zone is an enemy model and needs to be destroyed before you can control or dominate that zone. You get 1 point for destroying the objective, 1 point for controlling the zone, 2 points for dominating the zone.
Alright, Steve, so far this entire tournament you haven't had to take over Blackbane's Pirates, but I have a feeling today could be your day, Steve. Could be your day.
Why are you deploying them away from Ayana and Holt? That's just un-Australian.
Completely accidental, I assure you. I didn't even look where I armor at all was.
Oh, shit. Yeah.
Whoops. I was just like, meh. Today, we're going to go with them on the left. Today feels like a left Blackbones day.
Yeah, of course, you do have a Raider captain.
Yeah, she's over here.
So it's Blood Witches down the bottom. Mechanithral's in the middle there. And that's Blackbanes up the top there.
He's lined up the...
Rest
what was I saying? The Blood Witches opposite the Iron Fang Pikemen to try and deny them tough. But, again, is
so
the Blood Hag going to die straight
Raiders
away?
14. 14 on the charge. 18 if I want to just engage you. Like, run and engage.
Of course.
The Diagrath is there next to Asphyxius. Provide beyond death. Try and avoid the assassination.
And go.
Range 14 on those dicks, right?
Correct.
16 threat, which is exactly the front of my AD.
You mean 20 threat, but yes.
It's the front of my AD.
Yep. You definitely see they both know their armies well. Being pretty quick on the deployment. Colin's just thinking about where to put his raiders now.
What Colin's worried about is
exactly the front of my AD.
Widowmaker can actually shoot into
AD. Because there's 19 inches between us, I've got a threat of 20.
So he's just double checking with the
Kankerers
how far back
right?
Yeah,
put them.
Yeah, he's fine.
What does he need on the shot? Like 7
nah. I mean, I'm not going to win because it's Cricks.
Cardor can't beat Cricks, so it's fine.
Yeah, that's true.
I've got this in the bag.
Fuck,
in the bag!
He's even BMing
risk,
me by playing his shitty
would
caster
still be annoying
that's all Gaspy 2 or Scar. I don't know what I'm going to do.
This shit talk is...
Well, it doesn't look like I'm killing a whole unit of Satixus Raiders before the game starts.
It's a pity.
Maybe I should have played Butcher. Who knows?
Good luck. Have a good game.
Alright, so focus allocation. One to the Juggernaut, the rest
of the
rest.
You don't need to allocate. It's fine.
Yeah, I do.
Juggernaut can walk.
Juggernaut is not going to walk. He's going to run briskly his mighty fucking 8 inches.
Walk his way to victory.
Walk his way to freedom. Going to run Iris.
Oh, Eris.
So, this Kovnik will go. Advanced
it is interesting
here.
To see both of them have basically taken like the minimum jack that they can take. Colin
gonna
could have
this
taken
Kovnik.
An Arknight, I guess, for 1 point cheaper.
Going to advance through the lines this way.
Chris
kill
has
march.
A Juggernaut, which
gratuitous
is
use
possibly
of
his lowest
discipline.
Cost effective heavy
you don't
currently.
Know. This is
and
he's
Colin
gonna
Hill
walk sideways through these models.
Yeah, pretty much.
Talking to Colin before the game, the reason he has just Cankerworm is because he can rely on Vociferon if he needs to arc.
Well, since the Widowmakers can't shoot models on Tom 1, they
you
will
think that
just
Vociferon is another high-priority target, then, for the Airburst?
Yeah, I definitely think it would be.
To exactly where they started. Run backwards 1 inch.
Okay, which one do I want? Alright, I'm going to activate my Warcaster. He's going to put Tax Supremacy on
and
the regular
this is a display
pipe,
of Precision
the
War Machine here from Lab
range
Chris.
Is good. He's going to put
egregious
Fire Effect on the big gun
of
itself.
Discipline.
Energizer for one.
What he really needs to do with those pikemen is just cut off their pikes and just have empty bases.
And then he's just going to advance.
Dead.
Oh well, yeah, just shit anyway. Going to run the mortar to him. And the little dude behind it. Pikemen are going to go. These red guys, they'll shield wall advance.
Both units of pikes have received the shield march ability from the Iron Fang Kovnik, so they both move at speed 8 if they shield wall.
So he's jumping into shield wall straight away.
They're both Black Dragon, right?
Get charged by the fixes.
Charge threat 11, nothing extra special.
Charge threat 11, walking threat 10.
Yep.
They will destroy your Cankerworm. They will actually be able to cripple Cankerworm.
That's true. They'll get to pick where to hit.
They'll get to pick where to hit, where their ineffective shots will go. I'll run Gorman. 7-2. Do this unit, they'll go 8. So they can move through everyone.
That
so
unit,
that.
Too, has tactical supremacy on it, so it'll be able to move 3 inches at the end of the turn as well.
Risky move.
That's sickest Raiders have charged so far, anyway.
Eris doesn't have Hunter, right?
You're not going to get much
she
further up the table. Safely.
Go for Alexia and friends. They're going to advance. It's the Alexia and Friends show.
Again. And in fairness, he doesn't need to, as long as he's contesting that friendly zone down the bottom, which the unit down the bottom is the one with tactical supremacy.
Arcing Fire can't target something within 1 inch of an obstruction that's in the way.
Obstructions are what
so they don't count as a model in terms of blocking line of sight for Arcing Fire?
Precision real machine.
It's only models that block it. I'm going to zap up.
Chris just pushing around this massive blob of models at the moment.
Very carefully organized blob of dudes.
Have you got the mortar's card there? I know that's a weird request.
I'm going to turn that guy over in here to a four warrior. Shit. This roll's going to go for a run. Skiing to here.
So you literally can't target me when I'm behind the obstruction anyway.
Well, if I can't see you, I can't
correct.
See you.
So right, that was actually my question. I thought I can fire dodge the line of sight problem.
Nah, it dodges a whole bunch of weird shit. But...
Yep.
So, if the hag hides behind the skull mountain there, Chris cannot hit her with the mortar, but he can still airburst her.
Activation's gone through, so attacks... No, not yet. I've got a doge. The doge's going to run through here. Precision war machining.
It's going to teleport its way into there.
Victory. It's precision war machining at its finest. Then my activation's end, so trigger attack supremacy. But yeah, if you're behind that Skull Island, I cannot go.
The old Skull Island exploit.
So upkeeps Chris has out. He has tactical supremacy on the bottom unit of Iron Fangs, and he has fire for effect on the mortar.
Makes sense.
Alrighty. Oh, that thing's there. I guess I should put that on my belt or some shit. I don't have a belt. I'll put it in my pocket. It'll be fine. What's the worst that can happen? Gatsby gets 7.
Yeah, he does.
He chooses to... Oh, okay, 1. Okay, so... Eris, 12-inch shot. Don't want to give you an aim. So the Raiders are going to... You have no way to move her out of activation, right?
Not really, no.
Alright, the Raiders are going to run.
Colin here, by the way, has allocated a focus to Cankerworm, which is actually kind of useless, because Cankerworm, when he's inside Asphyxius' control area, can make a full advance at the end of his activation. Colin, at this point in time, is not aware that you can't run and still make that a move.
Because when you run, your activation immediately ends, and the scuttle move that Cankerworm can make still needs to occur inside your activation.
That would be absolutely bonkers. You can see he's setting up a line now. Nice arc, just trying to stay out of the threat range of the Iron Fang Pikeman.
The Raider Captain is going to run.
Okay. Yeah.
These girls are actually going to mini feet and run.
Really?
I think so. I wasn't going to, and then I thought about it and went, actually, yeah, I think we are. So, for better or for worse, we've declared it now.
Do you think that's a mistake, the mini feet?
I don't think that he really needs it, but I guess he's just trying to gain that little bit of extra board position.
Alexia, where's the token for Killbox? Important one. Magic weapons, the curse, and a stealth, I guess, if the case
I use I think it might not have been the most important of plays. Chris is really, his list and the way he plays is built for the long game. I don't think the extra advantage, there's not much extra board position that he's gaining from this. He's got, what, 3 inches, 4 inches? Yeah. I think he could have saved it.
Yeah, I agree. Definitely seems like it would have been more useful next turn. What magic weapons does he have in the list? Not many.
He's got Ayana and Holt.
Yeah.
Blackbane's going to get the charge run order.
Pretty sure that's cheating right there. What is that? You've got the Valor objective, right? So it's cover?
Correct.
Interesting to see the difference. But Colin is so much more spread out because Chris has locked everything in because he wants to give everything tough off the heroes. List can just really go as far as it wants. Gatsby's going to run up, or he's going to probably charge up.
He's going to charge up after he Ashen Bales the Zatixis. Because maybe Ashen Bales Zatixis is just a little bit broken.
He learned from the best.
This McThrall unit is going to run.
Now, do you think that Colin could have moved up further with his Satixis Raiders with the Ashen Veil on them? Or is that still a bit too dangerous because of the CMAs?
I think there's no reason he needs to get that close.
Yeah, that's fair.
This Surgeon unit's going to run.
Now, if Colin had gone first, I think that we would have seen the Satixis Raiders pushing up as far as they could to try and keep Chris out of the zones, because in order to get maximum effectiveness out of the Iron Fangs, they will have to stay in Shield Wall.
This McThrall unit. This Surgeon unit. I like your positioning, Cankerworm. You can't go anywhere. Looks good.
That focus you gave it, fucking strong, eh?
Yeah, he's gonna run, man. He's gonna run like a boss.
Well, he can run through Blackbane into nothing, so...
into a gap. Then he can run over here, then he can scuttle. Still be somewhere. I think he can scuttle after he runs, can't he? Pretty sure he can.
It's Chris.
It's the when his activation ends.
The rules make no sense anyway.
That's alright, we can just play it wrong and see what happens. The internet will tell me.
Yep.
And like we said before, he is wrong.
I tell him in a minute or two.
Okay, Bragman, you're just going to go hang out over here.
What do you think both players are thinking of their victory strategy at the moment? Just attrition? Try and win the attrition against each other?
Yeah, that's fine. Saxon, you're going to go hang out over here.
I think they both are looking at a long game and an attrition game. I think Chris's long-term game plan is definitely to win by scenario.
He's going to dominate that friendly zone. Over 17 turns.
Alright, so, Gatsby, you're going to go to there, do that, and that.
I'm not entirely sure what Colin's long-term game plan is.
Yeah, that's what I'm interested in. I mean,
can't.
Irisk is definitely easier to kill than Gatsby.
Gatsby's going to walk up. He's going to Ashen Veil the Raiders.
Does Chris have anything that could actually get to Gatsby and kill him?
Camp 2.
Alexia.
Yeah, like a loaded up Alexia.
Daryl is going to wander up, put up Beyond Death, and then just hang out.
He's cool.
Take it away.
Alright. No fixed maintenance, so control.
Kangaroo forgot to move and forgot to scuttle. Excellent. No movement, no scuttling, no running. It's good. Kangaroo was fine where he was. Yeah, he'll spend his focus to imprint.
Of all the fucking plays that matter at this point in time, I think he's probably least...
He's critical. critical to my long-term success.
Yeah, sure.
Long-term success.
Extra long-term.
I agree. We're in this for the long game.
Well, we are, actually, but that's all right.
Whether we want to be or not.
What's your caster's defense?
15.
Okay. Might actually be worth shooting you, frankly. Your army completely lacks high-value targets, apart from bitch over there.
I don't think you're within 20, but... I mean, there are worse shots you could make.
Pretty much. I mean, I can't even shoot Cankerworm to get your heavy off the table. It'll probably... Good Rucky, everyone, is probably a good bit as any. Either way, though, upkeep being 5 for effect...
There's so many targets. He's saying that there's no high-value targets, but
Blood Witches don't
Necrosurgeon, woman who does Necrosurgeons.
The Necrosurgeons are too far back.
And Hexron and Blood Witch. I realize that, but...
Also too far back.
I realize that they're too far back at the moment, but they are high-value.
Jack doesn't need anything. No Risen were made today because there was no horrible, horrible murders. So, I think that's it. Ashenveld Raiders are Def 18, right?
Correct.
Can you not be that, please?
I mean, you can make them not that. You just gotta hit that hard 9.
Effort. I think I'll do the big one, the obvious one, which seems to be I'm gonna have to feat this turn. But, it's not like it's a bad turn to feat.
Chris has allocated nothing to the Juggernaut.
Yep, so I'm going to go with the Rust Chris. He's going to pop his feet so he tags every model of his army with the no ignore all the effects rules.
Just ignore all the other effects though, right?
Yeah.
Doesn't ignore incorporeal, for example, because that would be upsetting.
That would be kind of funny.
So you tag all of those units?
Basically tag your entire army at this point.
Do you get that Stitch Throw?
I do not.
Yeah, Surgeon unit can charge. How do you like me now?
I don't think I like you at all, but that's not changing much anyway, so, you know.
So what else is new?
What is new? What is new in life? Not much.
Didn't tag Gaspy.
No.
You charge like a boss.
Fine, you fucking charge me. I dare you.
I think you did tag Cankerworm though, didn't you?
Actually didn't. Well, I did measure, so... No.
Huh. Okay. Yeah, Kanker Spanks.
I wonder if I could... Let's see, how much have I gone? Gone 3 and then 2.
Oh, I don't know. This is precision play at this point.
Yeah, it's true. Internet's going to tell me I fucked up anyway. So
yeah, they're going to tell you that was definitely
gonna,
8 inches.
They're going to tell me I fucked up waking up
the
today.
The feat is interesting at this point, I guess. I guess it's the right turn to do it.
Well, everything's going to be in range.
Yeah. I mean, is he going to hold back with his army?
So can you show me where the 14 went to out this way as well, while you're there?
Then what's
okay, so it's got that guy from that unit. It's got that whole unit. Yep, okay, thanks.
I was gonna take the gunshot at her.
At her?
Yeah. Double 6. I mean, I got a gun, might as well use it.
Would have been a strong start.
It would have been. Like, oh shit, still looking.
Pops a raider straight in the face.
Yep. Gonna airburst for 3. Target will be...
Oh, he's revealed his master plan. Let Colin know that he has airburst.
That guy.
There's a lot of immunity to blast in this list. The Styxus Raiders are immune to blast. The Witches
pikes,
can
right?
go incorporeal, and the Blackbanes are incorporeal all the time. It makes it a lot easier to clump together against the majority
really
of blast damage.
I see a whole bunch of guys are immune to blast. I'm just going to blast him.
Okay.
I'm just going to hard roll it. Need a 6. Hits shit.
But Epis is a spell, so it can be incorporeal. Right?
Yeah, which is
so
what Chris has done.
And that Mechanithral?
Alright, so I'm going to...
And I think that... No, don't
totally
think so.
With
yeah, it's just those two.
So, him... He's
power
8.
Dead. Rain. Right? 13, yep,
yep,
dead.
And on him,
dead. Corpse to me. Oh, you're backwards. Pagani!
Pagani. And I'll airburst again.
Oh, that was Steve! You son of a bitch!
Yeah, I
killed Steve. Barry's in. Barry, it's gonna be yours later.
Barry. Keep coming up with these names.
Barry's booty buccaneers. It's what Let's happens when Blackbane dies. Can we three?
Yep.
Alright, I can totally charge the shit out of him now. Yep. He's never gonna see it coming.
You know, it's kinda dumb, but I'm going to activate the mortar. The target will be...
Can't technically do that. Just telling you, the internet's going to tell you you're wrong.
Okay, well, fair enough then.
Got to measure from your caster to a point, Chris. To a point.
Caster back here, caster?
Yeah, fine. What are you aiming for?
So he decided to camp three. I was actually thinking then that could have been a bit dangerous because he said he was going to do another airburst. He would have been camping zero and been able to get bone shaker.
He's behind a wall.
Oh, but yeah, sorry about that. You're going to get snippets of Rage Against the Machine lyrics. That's going to happen because they're stuck in my head right now.
I'm going to target this mechcore.
Okay.
It's 20.
You got him. Hey, I was right about Gatsby. You're out right by about half an inch.
Yeah, that's what I was trying to record.
It's a 4-inch, right?
It is a 4-inch. So on him, reroll that. So, rat 3, 6, 11. Misses. Big die direction and small die is distance.
Well.
Direction 3 and 5 inches.
He skill shotted it. Where did it go? Who knows? Those three? So you're going to get... So he's immune, so two Mechanithralls. Because everything else
first
is immune.
First Mechanithral is dead, and second Mechanithral is also dead.
Alright, two corpses for me.
Yep. Yeah, go Mortar. Go for Iona and Holt. Holt will advance to here.
Yep.
Iona will advance to here. Yep. Iona gives the Widowmaker's magic weapons.
Yep.
Holt will pop his pop guns at nothing. I'm going to do this jug before I forget. Just going to actually just toe in there. Good job, jug. I'm going to activate my...
Trap card?
I do keep saying that shit. I do Widowmakers, actually. Orders will be to...
walk forwards and shoot things in the face?
Pretty much, yeah.
Is there an order for that?
The order is... Make people sad. Go there.
Rat 7, right?
Rat 7. You're just F-13, right?
Black Manes and the Chicks, yes. Yep. Both are 13.
This guy will shoot him.
Yep.
So, shoot here. Dead. This guy targets this guy, avoiding the cover.
Yep.
And in range. Dead.
He's in cover, right? Oh,
no,
7-8.
Avoiding the cover. Oh, okay. So this guy targets this guy, also would hit anyway. Dead. And this guy attempts to target you. In range.
Come back a tiny bit on your base, I think.
That's now way off. That's well over mine.
Oh, well then you're in then. Yep.
Before I forget.
So far, Chris hasn't really killed that much. That's not going to come back anyway.
Going to activate this Kovnik over here. He advances.
Yeah.
Taps these guys for Shield March. Going to activate this Kovnik over here. Okay, ignore all these guys, so he's going to advance. First two, then three. Then a bit extra. Shield March. These guys will go. I'm just tempted to mini feet or not. I think the answer might be no. So they'll just shield all events.
It's an interesting choice Chris has here. He's given the Widowmaker's magic weapons, and he can shoot at either the incorporeal Blood Witches or at Blackbane's, and he's chosen to shoot at Blackbane.
Interesting choice. They seem like a threat. Am I missing something?
Blackbane's course continuous fire. Yeah, Shield Wall and Iron Zeal both don't do anything against continuous fire because they both expire before you take the damage roll.
I'm going to go for...
Shooting those three are a cluster?
Yeah, they are. Sorry.
That's all right.
Why are you trying to make me play by the rules? I'm going to activate Elixir and Friends. Dalchev. I will Zephyr. Make a hole for Gorman.
Make a hole!
You become a thrall. I'm just going to then activate him in advance.
And you become a thrall.
Do Gorman... Can he fit through there? Let's find out. So go three.
I went second, right?
You did go second. Can't fit through there, though.
I'll be fine.
He's going to chuck a bomb.
Go for this unit of pikes. Their orders will be to chill wall, advance their mini feet.
Did they mini feet?
No, they didn't.
So it looks like Chris is doing a little bit of a combination. Harry asked before what he's going to use the feet for. Is he going to stay out of threat range, or is he going to get forward and use Iron Zeal and Shield Wall to combine with the lack of charging to make it really difficult to kill anything? Chris has done a bit of both, keeping the top unit out of threat range and using Iron Zeal and Shield Wall on the bottom unit that is further forward.
I think that's probably the right call. At least it gives him another effective turn in the next turn, because he's probably going to move in. And Colin has a choice here. Is he going to attempt to move closer, or can he just move back? Because really, he can probably stay, but keep enough stuff in the zone on the top of the screen to stop it getting controlled.
He might be just out on that one. You're short on this end right now.
And he's not going, and Chris is probably not going to try and dominate.
All right.
He may go in there, but he's not going to be behind the wall.
And seeing that'll be it.
Gatsby gets 7. Mini feet fades. Will upkeep side in touch, will upkeep out.
Just a note for people at home. I have seen this game. I was there when it was recorded, but Harry has not seen this game before.
Yeah, I got no clue what's going on.
So yeah, the bottom unit using Iron Zeal, as we said before, to press forward.
A bit interesting to me, because the Raiders have chain weapons anyway, so they're going to ignore the shield wall. I guess they're going to get their Iron Zeal bonus.
Cannot give or receive orders.
Minus 2 speed, that was the bit I was forgetting.
That's the big one. Means that Blood Hag over there can stay there where she can bother me later. Those birds are running in the middle of my army, and then my army is fucking sad.
No, really, he's getting 10 on 2 dice, but he does still have the mini feet as well. On 3 dice.
And he's not going to be able to get that many in range, because he was a bit conservative last turn.
I hear you.
They've got a threat range of 9 inches if you use Desperate Pace.
Yeah, I'm not going to give any to Kangaroo. We're good.
He's been fine with... He didn't need it anyway. He clearly doesn't appreciate focus.
No, 9 inch full threat.
Oh, because there was 2 speed.
Yeah,
so, I mean, 1, 2, I see probably 4, maybe 5.
I don't want to burn that, giving you fucking Risen.
So, potentially he could be getting 5 kills, and he could be ignoring top, but unlikely.
That's the spirit.
I think you're unlikely to get 5 kills, and I think if you...
And it's Nova.
Yeah, and then you lose your...
You lose your mini feet.
You lose your mini feet, and you lose half the unit of Stixes.
Okay. Not exactly sure how we should be playing this, so I'm just going to play it and see what happens. That's a bit of a problem.
I didn't see what he did with Alexia. Did he just kind of push that stuff forward a bit?
She's dirtling.
Yeah.
The whole unit gets it, right, if they're tagged?
Correct. That's like something I probably shouldn't mention on an open-air broadcast.
Yeah.
That is a certain disease.
Yeah.
But once everyone gets it.
The white bases that are not pikemen are Alexia and the Risen. And I'm pretty sure that's Alexia there behind Gorman.
So she's in good position to basically collect every single corpse.
Yeah. She's going to walk forward.
While being pretty
much there. Like a hand cannon at the Thrall Warrior.
All right.
Yeah, she's like... 15, 14 or something, basically.
It's dead.
Cheating. Why'd you see through your guy over there?
Martial discipline.
Can you imagine if Crick's got martial discipline?
That'd be pretty sweet.
It'd be fucked up. I don't want that.
Bone Shaker assassination on Alexia.
Alright, so we don't have that many options over here. We've got a slight problem. Can't deal with that. Want to walk forward and tag that.
So Colin's options this turn is he can just kind of advance forward and try and kill as many models as he can, or he can just reposition and try and get ready for the next turn without giving away too much of his army.
I figure he's going to try and do both.
Is
probably put a few models
it is.
In the way. Try and maybe bait Chris forward.
bit, so he can counterattack next turn, but keep most of his forces back, and hopefully use the necrosurgeons to collect any corpses that actually get, like, of models that actually get killed. Yeah, so it sounds like Colin's actually thinking about how much he wants to commit this turn. He's kind of coming to the same conclusion.
I can still run, right?
No.
Oh, really?
Orders, no, I can't order run is an order.
I guess it's a solo, of course.
He's going to have to commit too much of his forces on a turn where they're not going to be at maximum effectiveness.
Gatsby 2 hates it.
Yeah.
Turns out things don't change that much.
Yeah. Gatsby 3 doesn't like it much either. I agree.
For those of you wondering about what spells Colin has out, he's upkept Ashen Veil on the Styxis Raiders, and he also has Scything Touch on the Witches.
It's actually a pretty interesting spell on the Witches. They have like 3 attacks each or something, Dom?
They have 2 attacks.
Okay.
But they also have Gang, so their power actually gets to a decent level. Still not enough to do anything under feet.
These chicks are going to go. They're simply going to advance.
Alright. If Colin had saved the mini feet for this turn,
it would be amazing.
Push these Styxis Blood Witches into those pikemen and gain a more aggressive position.
I don't know if that's necessarily the right choice, because you can still put magic weapons on them for Mayana, but certainly would be better than last turn.
And they're good.
Check command on that one.
Which one? That one's okay. That one's just out. That one's out. And also probably broke. Do we want to kill like 4 or 5 pikemen?
Jokes. No, you don't get to.
Well, I get to try.
There's no desperate pace here because the Styxis Raider captain was the one who shot that thrall that Alexia had created.
Maybe I don't get to try. Don't know. Okay, so the Raiders are going to go. They are simply going to advance as well.
Yep.
So he's going to walk forward 5. This one's going to walk forward 5.
I like the change there. It goes from a threat range of 14 to a threat range of 7.
9 if I'd used Herbert.
Well, yeah, I think it's 9. But considering the alternatives, I'm fucking happy.
That's fair.
Because the Styxis Raider captain is fair and balanced.
And in addition to giving the Styxis Raiders no knockdown and plus 2 speed, also has a hand cannon.
He's 2 points right. Yeah, it makes sense. I just keep thinking, though, why isn't this Scar 1? No bone shaker, that's why.
Got that one wrong. Okay, the Black Banes are going to activate and also advance and then get shot to shit, is most likely. Seems pretty likely. Don't see a way to stop it happening either.
So looking at this list actually of Colin's that is in play, starting to see the point of it. Looks like a kind of incorporeal skew almost with the Black Banes and the Blood Witches. And obviously the Raiders as well almost become invulnerable with the Ashen Veil on them. So you've got like 3 units that are covering the entire board that can't be attacked by that much stuff.
And then you've got the Mechanithralls coming in behind them where you can put Carnage up. The Mechanithralls go to mat 7. And you can Scything Touch them as well. So it's 2 mat 7 power 13 attacks, which is kind of ridiculous.
What's their combo strike? Pack power 16 then?
It goes to power 17.
Half a point a model.
Fair. It's Crick's fair. Crick's level fairness.
I think about 3 Mechanithralls.
I'd rather you get possible.
There's a lot of things in life that you want that you don't get, Chris. Did you tag these Mechanithralls at all? I don't think you did.
It doesn't matter. It's based on when you activate.
So. Yeah, I know, but I don't think that unit's going to be in your favor.
Probably not.
Alright, so... I'd say they're out.
Nope, they're out.
Alright, so... Let's do...
I mean, you can move them into the feet. That'd be much appreciated.
Well, then they don't lose anything anyway, right?
No, they don't.
So, the
they get closer, so I can murder them.
Are going to actually move slightly into the feet.
Yeah, can I, like, get a quick switchy, like, swap all these guys for gun mages or some shit?
They are currently running.
You're really going to do that? You're going to call a judge, Jack? Jeez. I was 100% joking based off a joke last night.
Colin, are you really going to be that guy? Are you really going to just use inside jokes? I mean, really, Colin?
Come on. Cool Kids Club. alright.
Colin, German heads.
Ragman's going to run.
Yep.
I don't know what the fuck Cankerworm's doing. I'm not actually sure what any of the rest of these people are doing. I think they're kind of just dirtling, is what I'm doing, and I'm just spending time doing it. So the Mechanithralls are going to run.
If you want to know why Colin and Chris are making pyramid heads, you should all come down to Winnercon next time instead of going to a stupid christening.
I pretty much had the same amount of fun I would anyway. I didn't have to lose any games this way.
You through to there. We'll have you where you are, and you where you are, and we'll have you there. Alrighty. Luciferon's going to go...
So, it looks like my prediction was pretty much correct. He's left some stuff out as bait.
This surgeon unit is going to activate in advance.
But he's kept most of his horses back to be able to charge in there.
I didn't give them any calls, did I?
Chris isn't going to be able to take too much away.
Unfortunately not. Advance.
And he's lost his feet. Or he's used his feet.
There on the advance.
Very exciting game, this.
Out. Saxon's going to kick around. Gatsby is going to... I don't know what the fuck he's actually going to do, to be honest. He's going to walk forward in a minute. So, first off, Cankerworm's going to get out the way, I guess. Move, Kanks! Get out of the way!
Get out of the way, Kanks!
The blob of dudes on the left, slowly advancing towards the blob of dudes on the right.
Gatsby will come up. Having five at the moment. Do I want to swap anything? Happy with Ashen Vale where it is, happy with Silent Touch where it is. Don't want to cast anything. Guess I'm camping five. Barrel will come up. He'll be on death. And fuck it, we'll pass on.
No effects maintenance, so focus allocation will be I'll upkeep fire for effect and camp six. You keep not giving me risen, which is just rude, so I'm going to aim and shoot at that guy. First things first. So Rat 11 plays 18.
Could do with less than a 7. That is less than a 7, Chris.
Even though he's out threading with the Stixis, it looks like the Iron Fang's definitely getting the Alpha Strike here because of the feet.
That's true, but they...
I mean, it was a 7, so...
I feel time warped.
Yeah, you were... Well, that actually did happen, just so you know.
Yeah. Yeah, it did.
Chris doesn't have that many tools to remove like blocky models out of the way, so... The Iron Fangs don't look like they're going to be able to get as far back as they'd like to.
You'd be surprised, because Valachev has a spray. Alexia and the Risen can move through the line, and he can kill those models with placed Risen, or at least he could if Colin had actually killed anything. And then...
Because of Martial Discipline, all his models can just move through his lines. So he does have the tools to clear up a jam. Although it's not necessarily something that he wants to be doing.
It would have been really interesting to see if Colin had saved the incorporeal mini feet this turn and he just moved his black veins up on one side and the witches up on the other and kind of forced Chris to divide his attention and work out which unit he was going to give magic weapons to. Which threat he was going to try and deal with.
As it stands, he had to kind of keep their black veins back, because Ayana could just give magic weapons to the
Python on that side. He walked up again and beat it. I walked. It was amazing.
It was a great game. 40 minutes into the game.
I shot a dude too, yeah. He shot four dudes, I shot a dude. He's winning the dudes at the moment.
Yep. Alright, I'm going to activate the mortar. It's going to take a shot at Dazzle.
Uh-oh. There's going to be lots of dudes now. I think that's going to matter, so you said you've got the 20?
Definitely.
Judge! Anyone? I wouldn't mind checking that one. We can pause it if you want. I think you've got it, but if you don't have it, it'll matter, so. Judge!
Zad 20. I don't want it, because he's going to... I think I'm in range, but he's going to 4-plus it, which is less than 50-50.
Mortar shooting at Daryl.
Zad 20.
Is it in range? Yeah, is it in range?
Because I just declared
that's
the shot.
That's Rob, the judge with the magnificent beard. Rob Shepherd on the forums. Just checking to see if the mortar's in range to shoot at Daragrath.
So right now it's not over it. Right now it is over it. Right now, well, it, that,
Shit. That's over it now, I think. Yes. Okay.
Resume. 39 minutes on the clock. What's your defense again?
14. You got it.
All right.
Power 16?
So use that to figure out what we got. Power 16, so what's your armor?
Immune. You got him,
Okay, so, fine. What's your armor?
17.
Dice minus 1, you're dismounted.
He is dismounted.
On tanker space, what's your...
18. Sorry, 16. 16.
16,
whoa.
So dice minus 8, you take 2 wounds.
Daryl comes off his horse. 2-1.
And on your caster, your armor is fucking massive.
Yeah, it's 22.
22. So dice minus... I'm not even going to bother calculating that. I do 21 now.
Was that 2 to the 2 on Kankerworm?
2 to the 2.
You have not knocked anything out.
Okay. I thought I might have. I was a bit...
I really thought I'd nailed him in the cortex
really
with that one.
Him.
I really think that some of the other factions should get, like, a fire for effect solo or something, or artillery, so you can actually make some other artillery usable.
What one specifically for artillery?
I really just want an airburster. Oh.
Come on up.
I probably will.
Yeah, just, or even, like, in command range, artillery get +2/+2 or something like that. That'd be sweet.
I don't hate it.
Alright, so I'm going to activate Alexia and friends. Alexia will aim. Valachev will advance. Four. There.
This is Valachev, by the way.
What are you doing, spraying?
Well, at the moment, just checking line of sight.
Laser.
The great thing about magical sprays is they ignore the +2 defense bonus on the Stixis Raiders. And because it's a spray, you also ignore concealment, so Stixis Raiders go down to defense 14.
But he still needs, like, or something.
Can I see that Fire Blood Witch?
This one?
Actually, no, fuck it. I can see that one, can I?
From who? Valachev?
Yep.
To this one?
No, that one.
That one? Yeah, you can definitely see that one. Cool. Yeah.
Alright. And the rest of the Rizzo, what are you doing? Because you're aiming.
Sevens on Chris Dice.
Alright, Valachev is going to spray her.
Okay. Both of them?
Yep. Eight sevens?
Death 16.
No, you're not.
Yeah, I am. Oh, it's spray. Sorry,
it's a spray.
Spell,
it's
you're
magical,
right. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So
yep.
Need a seven. Kills. Yep. Need a seven. Kills, get both corpses.
Yep.
Yeah, that's what you needed, though.
Alexia will boost a hit with this guy targeting her. So, rat is seven, need an 11. That'll do. I'll get. No.
Rat is seven, need. Yeah, yeah. Yep.
11. You don't have any surgeons within range?
No.
Then I'll take your corpse as well.
You got it.
More corpses for the corpse queen. And that'll be it. Thanks, actually. Yeah, stupid. The command.
Does he have any way to give out Pathfinder apart from the feet?
This guy's going to charge that raider. I know it's like needs a fucking stupid number, but it's the dog. Might as well go for it.
And it's kind of irrelevant in this game.
If he needs it, he's got Artifice of Deviation.
You're...
Not enough.
No, I need
Ashen Bale.
A 10. I would have hit you without Ashen Bale.
Correct.
So, 4?
Yep. Is he 7 or 6?
Yeah, 7.
Yep. You got room?
Yep.
It's a 5-inch AoE. It's Pathfinder for your troops, and it's rough terrain for your opponent's troops.
Let's see.
There's an assassination going on in the next table, by the way. That's why the sounds are coming through. They're getting a bit loud, a bit rowdy.
Go for Ayana and Holt. Holt will advance. I think I'm in range, but I don't really want to make an issue of it. I guess that. Make me roll 6 times. Yep. Ayana's going to attempt to give them magic weapons. 9-inch range.
Can she see them? You're aligned? Yep.
That's why I just check.
Yep. Looks good. So and it's within 9?
9. It's a command. So command. Yep. So go shoot that raider. Actually. Shoot that guy. And.
That one I get a corpse on.
The blood rich Chris is shooting here is the one that was out of formation last turn.
Please help him out.
That guy. That check 12 on that one. Yep.
Do you think he's taken a bit too long to...
Yeah, I was just thinking exactly the same thing. But it's probably going to be the most important turn of the game.
Kovnik, chill much. They'd lose their mini feet.
In terms of getting everything set up correctly.
They mini feet again!
That would be bad.
I would
prefer if they did not do that. Mm-hmm. That is my preference. I've registered my preference. Please buy.
Yep. Stitchrolls can't sack shots, can they?
Nope.
Okay. So it's kind of fair enough, but yeah, I mean, it's been like 6 or 7 minutes already in this turn, and he hasn't used either unit of Iron Fang.
Widowmakers are all going to go. They're all going to aim. This guy's going to shoot that Raider.
And he's just taking a long time to think about
yep.
targets that he's going to shoot at, and really it doesn't matter that much. He's cleared out the models in the way to shoot at something, to build some stuff.
That's him looking at Eris while he does that. He's like, this is how you do it.
Okay, so I can't see through this guy. So
despite the fact that Iris has missed the Raiders when she attempted to shoot off Ashen Vale, none of the Widowmakers have actually missed.
I'm going to laser everything.
Kind of can't see him, so I'll shoot that roll.
I like that package of models, actually. Just having basically five, like the ability to remove 5 infantry models a turn. A really, really long range.
Fuck, I'm tempted to aim and shoot at more Raiders at this rate. Works very well so far. That's a stitch draw. I'll shoot at that Raider. Yeah, wait, before you do that, I should actually check range. Yeah, I can. Fuck, I know even what. I'm gonna shoot that outside. Okay. Going to go for a walk.
Yep. Indeed.
And unfortunately, martial discipline doesn't let you move through non-lift models, which is what that objective is. Trust me, I play fierce.
Just trying to think what to do with my caster. I'm not sure how many of my guides I really want to throw away.
Advance, face backwards, drop focus. Always plan B.
Always plan B. I'll activate my pikemen over here.
Yep.
They'll advance. Shield wall advance.
And turn backwards.
Well, I'm not ready to brag, but I'm a very good player.
So I'm kind of a big deal in my local meta.
I don't mean to brag, but I might actually be a big deal in my local meta. I want to stay out of range of your dudes.
Can you walk through that objective? You can't.
No, I can't.
Woohoo! I knew there was a reason I didn't attack it last turn. I was like, that's totally going to slow down one pikeman. It's going to be worth it. It wasn't worth it.
It wasn't. Correct. I mean, I always do question plays that involve don't killing models, because this is a game about killing models.
Agreed.
Still.
The seldom used not kill plays is not actually as good as you'd think.
No.
Or perhaps is exactly as good as you'd think.
So, Chris here, again playing very conservatively.
He's keeping the majority of the unit back, and he's brought forward just enough guys to be able to clear the zone so that he can dominate.
Yeah, that makes sense. Good play.
Man, don't you just love martial discipline? The fucking care going into this play, I'm going to punch him.
Sure.
Need a 7. Nope. Oh. I'm going to do a 2-man C-mat with the captain leading on her.
Yep. Need like a 3.
I think you got double 1. Punch that thrall. Kill him. Oops, and you're knocked down, by the way. And then you're dead. And then this guy fights that one.
That one? Which is number 3? Which is that one over there?
Dead. And kill the switch.
Is that enough for a check yet? It's not, is it?
No. This guy is going to attempt to charge that thrall. It's good.
Yep, thrall on thrall action. Hey, that's over the wall. Yeah, boy! Woo!
It is over
Yeah, defense too high. Mechanic thrall too strong.
Too strong. Yeah, that's the jack. Going to go for my warcaster. Let's go 5. Check control. Do I have the hagging range?
Not right now.
How far am I?
You're like a quarter inch out at most.
I moved 4 inches.
I think you said 5 when you went there, but I don't know.
I get 5 more.
Sure. We're going to judge that again, I think. Judge!
Judge!
We said it second! Our judge call is better!
Our judge...
Ours is more interesting, Rob! Come on!
Actually, interesting. I wonder if you could bone shaker some of those models in the back. Move them forward, kill the models in the front.
You ask yours first, Jack. I think you probably got it, but can't tell the angle.
I'm more than happy to accept a judge call over whether I'm going to airburst your model that is critical to your plan of
fairly
stopping...
fairly important.
It is slightly important.
Little bit.
If Chris has this and he manages to airburst the hag, then Colin's got no way of getting rid of Tuff for the rest of the game.
Dog. Guy.
If he doesn't...
then,
all those pikemen are dead.
Interesting thing here, he actually has more movement with Irisk, but he doesn't have enough movement to get past.
Rob, these guys move, and they're done, because the shredder happens.
At present,
damn it!
Am I within 14 inches
of the hag?
Of the hag.
This is not at all critical, so I don't want you to feel pressured. Now, we could just take this out of the way if you want.
And those pikemen, too, had more movement to move forward. So,
yep.
This is a situation that could have been avoided.
That is currently short. You are not within 14 inches. Excellent.
Oh,
might be a problem for Chris now.
Now, do you declare airburst? Oh, you don't.
I'd say it's definitely a problem now.
But that's as far as you can
go,
right?
Still actually moving.
But you can't make it.
Yeah, so in that case, I'll shoot.
Yeah, that,
touch.
That feels like a pretty critical mistake.
Did you have... Okay. Was that half
an inch? Like, yeah, half an inch.
All right.
Oh, wait. That's way more than half an inch.
Yeah,
there you go.
Yeah, okay, cool.
Okay, so in that case, plan B. Spend 3 focus. Ah, shit, you got sacks.
I do have Saxon.
Alright.
It's one of those things, like, when you're playing with martial discipline, you don't think about it. You just feel like, you know, you can move wherever the hell you want.
And trying to eyeball that 40 inches, too, can be a bit hard.
Yeah. It probably, if I were Chris, I probably would have been focusing on making sure it happened. I would have given myself leeway, but, you know, it's fair enough.
First up, then, I'm going to boost the hand cannon at... No, she's engaged. That's not going to work.
They're always saying, Chris, if you're listening, is that you're a shit guy?
You're pretty bad.
That Mechanithral?
That Raider?
Okay. The Witch?
Man, witches are less effective than, like...
Mechanithrals?
Mechanithrals at this point. It's kind of sad, actually. Can I get Artifice?
What was that?
Artifice of Deviation? Can I get a 5-inch ring, please?
I don't have one, I don't think. Oh, I might do, actually. Hang on.
I've got one.
This turn is definitely dragging on, and we still haven't seen the top unit of Iron Fangs activate yet.
I don't think I bought a 3. Ah, hang on. No, that's a 4.
14 minutes?
I can tell you from my notes that
you got one? You
right there.
Chris uses up 16
this
minutes
put
this turn.
On it. So, like, that?
Yep.
That work?
It's hard to count past 10.
There we go.
You've also got to remember that we've had 2 clock pauses here, because we've
balance.
Had 2 judge calls.
Balance. Fair and all balanced. And I'll camp. Might as well take my gunshot at that guy.
Sure. Is he a 6?
Yeah.
Corpse to number... Actually, that might be... I think that might be a corpse to number 4. Who's closer?
Well, while you're working that out...
He was 13.
You're going to have to rush it and touch. Nah, going to activate this Kovnik. He's going to advance here. Shield march?
Yep.
Going to go for... These pikes, they're going to shield wall many feet in advance.
So we have the Iron Zeal coming out for the top unit, bringing them to armor 22, as long as they're in shield wall.
Where's my flag bearer? There you go. Throw in the zone there.
You think it might have been worth trying to kill that objective this turn?
I do, and the reason I think so is because I don't think it's a good idea to move more pikemen towards the blood hag, where they can die. That's the only reason, and I wouldn't have moved them closer to the Blood Hag, and so I would have thought about what I could do with them instead. And when they're in Shield Law and Iron Zeal, they're going to be
after that.
They're still going to get burned either way by the Black Bane.
So
where's the unit leader?
Unit leader is here.
Okay.
In fact, he probably actually goes there.
Depends how aggressive he's going to get with the Blood Hag, I guess, whether he's going to make this turn
play,
or whether he's going to be a bit more cautious and just... Make sure he has the Blood Hag for later turns.
Sorry. Not sorry. Actually go there.
He might not have had six to get all the way to there. I'm not
eight
certain.
Eight
inches. Oh, they're eight. Sorry. Eight. Yeah, yeah. Yep.
And that's it for my turn. No, Gorman. Of course, Gorman is the last one.
Balachev is really far forward there, too. And that is... It's a risky play from Chris, but it's one that definitely can play off.
We have seven. Beyond death drops.
Score a point. Go.
Sure.
Because he's going to lose some pikemen this turn. Last turn he lost none, which was amazing. But this turn, he's not going to have that same run of nothing dying. So we can expect some thralls to be able to come down this turn. And with Valachev that far forward, you place the thralls in formation, which means with Valachev far forward, the thralls get much further forward placements.
So if I kill those three models, I can straight up charge you with Gatsby.
Just talking about Colin making an assassination run on Chris here, he can drop mobility on himself.
Question is, what are you at the moment? You're a 17-19?
17-19. No, 17-18.
Is he 15-15 base, is he? Need 11s to hit. If I hit one, dice off two. I don't know. I don't like it. I don't like it. Screw it. So, are we going to be cycling? So they're currently armor 14, 18, 18, 18, 18. They minifeated the turn before, right? Did these ones minifeat this turn?
Correct.
Okay. So I want to kill these five and take their corpses to me.
Five, I think.
Kill those and don't give corpses. That's what I want to do. Can we do it? Can we kick it? Yes, we can. Probably not. We probably can't kick it, to be honest. So, we upkeep Scything Touch because I'm not sure whether we need to or not, so we're going to. I feel like I want Ashen Veil, but I'm not sure that I can afford to...
Yeah.
I could.
It wouldn't matter. It really doesn't matter.
You know what I miss right now? I almost miss with Greylords.
Do we want to cycle... Scything Touch this turn?
He's in a good position.
Alexi is in a very safe position. And she's also in a position where she's going to get the majority of those corpses, but she's not going to get the front line of pikemen.
No.
Possibly the one closest to her.
Can you feed him whip? Kills. Does he have reach?
He does not.
Kills that front line.
You are Regret Town.
Alright. So Jack has won the other semi-final, and he's just telling Colin and Chris what happened. He can't hear him because he doesn't have a microphone.
Did you just outskill him?
Or you can kind of half hear him.
With one of them.
One of them. Only one of them.
Oh, Veil wasn't in the feet? Jesus. Okay, so. We are going to upkeep Ashen Veil. We've upkept both. Which means.
Oh, no, sorry.
That isn't going to happen. That's going to have to happen.
Problem, I guess, with having so many units that you have to move around and think about how he's going to get past that first line of pikemen and save as many attacks as possible for the line behind them. And if he wants to implement the Blood Hag's aura, he's going to have to move them first as well.
Oh, so those ones already don't have tough. Okay, so this one's going to go first.
That's the Necrosurgeon unit?
Yeah, he's activating the Necrosurgeon. Yeah.
He's moving up so he can grab those corpses.
Is he in command?
I don't know, so I'm going to say no.
Yeah.
So he can only move into command.
All I have to say is, when are they adding Necrosurgeons to Scorn?
It's not much.
Delta but... might be playable.
That's roughly right.
Yep. So he's 1.5 to it, and then he's got 3.5, so halved, 1.75, so nearly 2. Just hanging out there. Alright. So. We're going to do... Oh. We're going to poop out 3 Mechanithralls. Because forgetting that right now would be a really bad move.
Even though the feat isn't up this turn, Colin's still not getting the charge, and the reason he's not getting the charge is just because of placement. He needs to advance because he just can't charge in a straight line.
It's not too bad overall, though, because he's going to get the mini feat anyway. He should have pretty decent chance. He is losing, I guess, the effectiveness of having multiple attacks.
Okay, so the...
Possibly necromancy is a bit too useful.
Raiders are going to raid or not?
No carnage from Gaspy.
Raiders gonna raid.
Seems like a mistake as well. I don't know if he's holding Gaspy's turn.
Yeah. Okay. So the raiders are gonna go. They're going to activate and advance. They're gonna mini feet.
Yeah.
That's actually like one of my favorite things about Iron Fang Pikeman is that defense 13. It's just one higher than. And you kind of expect on a shield wall unit like that. Cause a problem on mat 6 troops.
She's gonna walk forward 7 straight to there. No, you're not. Well, I don't think so. So, alright, I'll place
her. No, you're actually fine, because you got through there.
Yeah.
Like, you actually shifted when I said free strike, you actually moved it in the free strike zone. Like,
I think.
No, you're fine.
So she's there.
Yeah. I was just like, yeah, well, actually, with the. In fact, could you get, like, more nervous problems? That would be useful.
I'll work on it.
The Barocca is certainly helping.
We'll get into that one.
Oh, I could have fitted you with him. Yeah, actually, that's
the next we'll get into like, that one. There. We'll get into that one. There. We'll get into that one. There.
The hateful sea witch. Finally, reckoning is at hand.
And the mini feed is up. Chop. Sure. So we'll go her whip here. Needs a 7. She'll miss. Probably should have gone with carnage first. Face here. She'll hit. Pow. Not enough to... Well, that'll kill you.
What's your pow?
9.
Yeah, that'll kill.
Oh, 8, sorry. 8. But that's still 20 still something.
Not. And I get
and you're in. And you're not in tough.
Yeah, exactly.
And I get the corpse.
I get tough. No, I don't.
We'll go her...
I prevented her him for what it's worth.
Her whip with her face on that one. Got it, and dead.
Yep.
And then we'll go the other way onto that one. Miss. Miss. So we got another corpse again. We'll go whip with her face. Whip.
Hits.
Kills dead.
Actually, just check top of that.
Corpse.
Check on the hag.
Yep. Oops, don't take corpses from my other necrosurgeon, that's bad. Okay, so. We left 2 of them alive. That seems bad.
The other problem now is the Stixus Raiders are way up forward. We've got the entire unit out there. They're in aiming range of Iroh. And if they lose Ashen Vale,
they're
just going to get murdered. And he's only killed
3, I think. Either way, it's not great.
Gaspy's going to go. He's going to carnage and feet. And just...
Alright.
Stay where he is, basically. He was going to do interesting shit, and then I decided that I couldn't be bothered.
I could just dodge.
Tankerworm's going to activate. He's
Let's
going
play
to
some ball four. Machine.
He's going to stab that guy. Hit. Dead.
Wait, what's your pal?
13. And then he's going to
scuttle. I thought you were like 10 or some shit.
Nah.
No.
He's 11 armor pierce that goes up to 13, and then he's 13 on the butt. Alright. Daryl.
The Gatsby's beat in this matchup? Probably not. Really that useful?
Feeling a little bit scared now that he doesn't have a horse. Back up a little bit beyond death from over here, where it's safer. Doesn't like it over there. There was bad. Came forward, got shot in the face, walked away.
You know, if you're any other kind of model, you'd actually just be dead. But no, I'm Daryl. I've got My Little Pony fucking horse.
Correct.
I'm not bitter about that character. No, sir, not at all.
Nobody is bitter about that character. It's fine.
Kind of a menacing force that Chris has set up there.
The Iron Zeal and Shield Wall on the top unit, and just kind of the inability to get dudes on the bottom unit. The fact that Chris has played a really good game here. He hasn't overcommitted at all. He's just committed exactly, I think, what he needs to commit.
Yeah, I'd agree. Really, really good play. I feel like Colin's taking a bit too long here as well.
No way to do that. No way to do that.
Why would you play Boomhowls and Kador, please?
Especially after the advantage that the second player has is seeing how long the first player is taking in their turns, especially in this kind of matchup where they know it's going to go long.
It
feels like knowing that Chris took so long in the last turn.
So I think the Blood Witches have to go next. So the Blood Witches are going to get the charge run order.
Yep.
This one's going to charge.
If he continues to play last turn.
That guy?
Sure.
He could maintain the time advantage, but it kind of looks like he's going to take even longer than Chris did last turn.
I'm going to counter charge you.
Yep, go for it.
Counter charge you there.
Yep.
I've got him down as taking a 17-minute turn.
Do you get that corpse?
No.
I don't get. No one gets that corpse.
No, wasted.
Wasted.
Wasted opportunity. So in that case, these ones will also.
Fuck, I love doing that. That's just so good.
Yeah. This one will charge and go to there.
I love this job.
This one will charge. And go to there. On you and you. She's going to try for a charge on Alexia. Oh, actually, no, she's not. Fuck it. On an error, sorry. No, she's not. She's just going to run.
Well, you don't have Pathfinder, yeah, so you correct. Can't get there.
She's just going to run. She's going to run.
Yep.
First deck here. Hits it. He's going to be dead.
Explodes.
Yep.
The blood explosion thing happens, or?
No. I want the corpse.
Okay. Alright. The McCrawls are going to go. No, they're not. Saxon's gonna. Well, we've got the mover. Oh, Saxon's gonna go. He's gonna give them reconnaissance.
Yep.
They're gonna activate and advance.
Necrosurgeon has a poop load of corpses there. Spent three, he's got like another 10.
That's something that's definitely in Colin's favor here. If that necrosurgeon doesn't die, there's just gonna be a continual stream of mechanothralls coming into that zone.
That's true, but I mean, Chris has the same kind of advantage with Alexia anyway.
The Risen Thralls aren't quite as good as Mechanothralls.
We're going to go Laser Gun.
They do decent up against each other, though.
We're going to go...
It's like way short.
Oh, there's also Souls on him. Only one.
No.
No, probably not. Was there a guy there or not? No? Okay.
I was had to stay away from your...
You got it. So we'll go Swing here. We'll hit.
What's your man?
Seven.
Carnage. Oh, yeah, of course, Carnage.
Death.
Yep. So I die.
Cool. That's all of them, because I forgot to move that one. Any of them? Well, let's just sit in there. You're good, you're good, you're good. Where are you going to go? You can...
Colin has not committed the Blood Hag, which means that Chris is currently out of range to airburst her, which means he can't airburst her and then move back into a safer position.
Are you able to put Martial Discipline on Eris? Does it have to be a unit? I keep making look things
you
up.
You mean Tactical Supremacy?
Yeah, that one.
Right there.
That's what I meant.
Yeah, he can put Tactical Supremacy on himself, and also he's got Energizer.
Surgeon's gonna go three. Pain of Mechanothralls. Two Pain of
Mechanothralls.
Maybe, I mean, you're getting the Blood Hag, but that's a big focus investment.
Do you want necrosurgeons? Don't do share, because sharing is caring, and necrosurgeons don't give a fuck about the rules.
Oh, I forgot to move them. That's okay. I forgot to move the stitch rolls. Doesn't matter. Alright, the McThralls are going to get a charge run order.
Yep.
This one's going to charge that one.
Yep.
This one's going to charge that one. This one's going to charge that one. This one's going to run. 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 First one. They're currently armor 22.
22.
So we're doing big punch. We'll hit. Power 17. Power 15, sorry. Dead.
Power 15. Yep. Dead.
Second one.
I'll get a corpse. This guy?
You'll hit. No. Is that cocked or not? Up to you.
Reroll.
Yes. Third one. Got it.
Hits.
Tough check.
On my time. Nope. So this guy?
Yep.
Move him. I get a hit.
Do that!
Okay, the Blackbanes then are going to get the charge run order. Oh, you got the laser? So he's got Balachev?
Yep.
So he's charging Balachev.
The Blackbanes are using their incorporeal to get through to try and kill Balachev here. This is a crucial role here.
If he doesn't kill Balachev, then there's a whole bunch of thralls going down and in very aggressive positions.
And not only that, but
if you have a look at Valachev's positioning, there's a lovely line of models just in front of him, where a model with a magical spray 8 would just be able to annihilate a whole bunch of dudes.
That'd be sweet.
Charging that guy in a second? Yeah, charging that guy.
Yeah.
Is that charge? Or
yeah, charge at that guy. This one's going to charge at that one. This one's going to charge at that one. 10 puts him in there. He's going right to the front of that mechanical. Blackbane's going to run. Alright, so first one, Valachev. Misses it. Every fucking time. Here. Got it. Power 10. Dead.
Dead.
And also a Blackbane.
Becomes a Blackbane.
Yeah.
So I'm going to make you the new leader.
And he's missed Valachev. Sadness.
I'm excited to see this now.
Here. It.
Failed.
7, so not enough. And here. Miss. That's them, that's them.
It does look like Colin's sped up at the end of his turn, though, at least.
Still a slow turn.
Yeah, but he was activating. Like, it seemed like he realized halfway through that he was taking too long. The activated.
She's actually going to run.
The Mechanithralls and the Blackbanes pretty quickly.
Derek's already gone, you've already gone, you've already gone, I think. Whether I like it or not, that's me.
Okay, no effects maintenance. Wait, no, he's on fire? Or is he, or.
Yes. One of them's on fire, yeah, he got hit.
He got hit, so.
One fire roll?
No, he's not on fire. Roll
it. It looks pretty bad for Colin at this point, because he really didn't
kill
that much.
Full count. Upkeep fire for effect. Does that count as spending focus? If I upkeep fire for effect?
Yes.
Then check if I'm in feet.
You are.
Okay, well, you get a soul, and hopefully that's the only soul I give you.
Yeah.
Okay, then yeah, you do that. And I poop out 5 thralls. Alright, I'm so glad you didn't kill Valachev.
I really tried hard.
Valachev is going to have a fucking... He's going to have a good day.
Can't believe that.
Yeah.
Oh, I can't believe that. I mean, it happens, but still, it was upsetting. I'm not gonna lie.
I'm gonna put this this way.
Would have really liked to turn him into a black bat. Would have been really good.
Well, he's also pretty far forward, so.
It's starting to look pretty bad for him, but that Asphyxius list does have a really good long game, especially with the hag still alive.
I think about this.
Yeah, that's true. Looks like Chris is gonna try and dominate his zone this turn.
Where are your stitches?
Yep.
I mean, it's still only 1 point. He has to survive for another 4 turns, basically, and kill that objective on the
damn
other
it
side. Maybe out of clear the other zone, but...
He's a 12, right? Or 13?
Who?
Balachev.
Balachev is a 13.
Needed a 5.
Yep.
Ah, well. Mortar's going to go first. He's going to shoot the objective.
Yeah, he'd have to focus a lot of attention on it.
No. Yeah, well, I repicked up the die, but fuck it. Hit your objective. Power is 16
so
on the objective. Dice minus 2. Takes 4.
And you're going to get him?
Yep. Dead.
You're going to get her?
Dice minus 4. Takes 7.
What's his power? 8?
Alright.
Me, and you don't hurt him.
Do you have the large blast marker I have?
I don't suppose I get him.
I don't think so. Oh, it's 4 inches, isn't it? You might.
4 inches.
Nah, No, that's going to be short. Too easy.
Alright. Iris is going to go round two. Fight. Shoot her. Hit her this time.
Got it this time.
Get rid of that. Also, you're dead.
That one?
Yep. Alright, so that's crucial. Ashen Bale is now off the Texas Raiders. Jesus. Those Texas Raiders are dead.
Probably should have chucked a bomb out there. In fact, I might actually just have Ross do that.
Rusk hasn't activated yet, right?
He has not. I've found two models, these two. Oh, before I forget. Corpses.
Are gone.
So, who's incorporeal? This guy?
So, not incorporeal, you mean? Those four?
Those four are non-incorporeal.
Correct. I've marked the two that are incorporeal still.
So, from upkeeping fire for effect, Colin has one soul from the feat so far.
And that's probably all he's going to get. There's a fair amount of spellcasting in this list.
Those McThralls did kill two, didn't they? They did kill two, correct?
Yeah.
Because there's souls here.
Yeah, they did.
Which is where I ran him to.
Yeah, I probably should have shot him, actually. Oh, well. So lovely. I don't really want... I need black paint. In fact, I'm probably just going to dominate undead that guy. Alright. Let's go for Alexia and friends. Their orders will be to advance. I do kind of want to put Battle Lust on them, just so they kill your thralls, but I'm just going to have to trust in dice rolling. Always a perilous task. Hello.
Is crafting a thrall a magic ability?
Crafting a thrall is a magic ability. Although, I don't believe that's what Alexia's going to do here.
Artifice doesn't get upkept, right?
No, it's not even an upkeep, so you can't get rid of it. It's upkeep removal.
Fuck it. I was going to try and take it out, but I can't get it out of there.
I'm thinking now, maybe Colin's plan all along is just not to kill anything and make Chris time out.
So he's going to go walk around.
Seems to be taking a long time, just trying to get his models where he wants them to be.
Actually go
it's a really important Valachev roll.
Valachev will go first, and we'll... No, do I have done everything? Yes, I have. Spray. Spray the black bane in front of it. And actually...
Gatsby gets a soul.
Can I see through them? Oh, okay, yeah.
No, he's not...
Oh, he's the glorious spray. That's awesome.
I'd scale for this.
Yep.
Do I get the Mechthrall?
I don't think so if you line up base like that. I think you miss him just. You get three.
But four is fine.
Yeah, three so and yep.
Seven... Hit,
13. You got
no, 6, that's it, because...
Barry's dead.
Yep.
Tim, you've got control.
Hit that guy, and kill him. This guy.
Which one? That one.
Miss the next raider, and finally your sea witch. Hit the sea witch, roll damage.
And the sea witch is dead.
So oops. Before that, I collect this corpse, you collect that corpse. Yep. So everyone, equal trade.
So now they've lost their +2 defense against range attacks as well.
Three-man C-mat on that thrall, 1, 2, 3.
Yep.
With the guy in the back leading, hits, auto-kills you. Power 7, no, it doesn't auto-kill him. Two-man C-mat with the guy in the back.
It did. Yep.
Hits your guy, power 9.
Nope.
Failed to kill you. Two-man C-mat on him. Hits you,
six. What's the 6, yep.
Power is 9, kills you. Yep. Kills your Blackbane.
There are also souls on Vociferon as well.
Where's my laser?
I'm a charging my laser.
So you're not engaged?
No.
I'm gonna boost and hit a dominate undead with
that. So I get two souls?
Correct. Hit the dominate undead. How likely is it to kill black beings?
So Chris's play here is dominating undead, a black beings ghost raider.
What is the best
an incorporeal Black Rain Ghost Raider, moving through the other models there to attack Black Bane.
That is amazing.
Actually, oil bomb, I can explosion bomb him and get all four of them, so it's fine. He's going to try and go for it. Whoops.
You're going to hit this, aren't you?
Swinging him, actually. Swinging him. I do hit it. You're on fire.
Wait one second.
Well, I rolled an 11, so what's your power?
Ah, they're magical. I didn't think they were for a second.
No, they are.
What'd you roll as damage?
I haven't rolled it. I rolled an 11 to hit.
No death. And he is... Wait. And he's immune to fire. Okay, so he'll take 2 points.
2 points. You guys are pathetic.
But that guy's dead, right?
No, he isn't. He's actually still alive. But he's corporeal now.
Black Bane lives, sadly. Chris only managed to roll 4 on the damage.
Gonna go for Gorman. He's gonna advance. Gonna chuck his corrosion bomb at you.
Yep.
Direct hit. So everyone just, these three models just die. And so does he.
A acid bomb there from Gorman does a power 12 to everybody under the AoE.
No stitch rolls to pick up those corpses?
No, good. Unfortunately not.
Alright.
I didn't move them last turn.
Gonna activate this Covenant here. He's going to, he's just gonna advance. So, you'll go to there.
Yep.
That's so successfully. Swing at him.
I love that that's like his least used ability.
Does
yeah, you can have it.
Alright. Just kills you. Fucking ghosty pirates. Get wrecked on.
They did.
Go for Iona and Holt. Iona will advance. Here. Actually, go to there instead. See here. Holt will advance to here. Holt is going to go first. Well, they're in command. Holt will shoot your stitch roll. Tired of you collecting your shit.
Yep. Well, I mean, are you going to keep him or not keep him?
Well, actually.
We kept one. So.
Kept one. Okay. I rolled the same run in. So hit him.
Yep.
Shoot this guy. Kill him.
Yep.
Iona gives them magic weapons again. The pikemen, the green unit.
Yep.
Go for...
Will be interesting to see if he kills the objective this turn.
Go for the dog, it's going to charge that guy. Need an 8.
Got it.
One sec. You got any stitches?
Yeah.
Okay, you're closer. I'm 6. Yeah, you collect it.
No. I go from this one, not from... It's called
okay.
Collection
model. In that case, I'll collect it.
Did he have enough to get all the way back? He's only 6, right? Not 7? Or he's 7. Oh, yeah,
seven.
You're good, sorry.
Keep saying he's 7.
Yeah, I keep thinking he's 6.
You know why he's 7?
I keep hoping for him to be 6.
Can I activate this green covenant?
If I ask enough times, he'll eventually become speed 6.
Your turn becomes... shield march on these dudes. So the green unit now has shield march.
Yep.
Widowmakers are going to go. They're all going to aim. Again. Actually, no. What's the defense of your Scarlet?
14.
How many units are left in this guy?
And those Widowmakers are just doing incredible work.
He's in range.
Like, they're
so
just going four models every single turn.
I can't ignore those guys for line of sight purposes. Fair enough. Fuck up, this is all lame. This guy here is going to shoot at that thrall. Yep. Dead.
Hang on, I'll check. Looks like no.
This guy is going to shoot at that raider over there.
Yep.
Rat 9 and 5 hits you because you're a raider. Your witch is dead.
Ah.
Not an Ashman. Before you do that, I get your corpse, I think.
Yes, you do, on this one.
Yep.
Yep.
So that's those two gone. This guy is going to... Okay, this guy will shoot him. That
yep.
Thrall. Actually, yeah, he's got a line there. Thrall's dead.
That one, I think I do.
And this guy's going to take the shot that way. Yep.
Yep.
Cleared the zone before the Iron Fangs even activated.
Get your corpse.
I get that corpse. I think I'm closer. Oh, maybe not.
Still 9.
There's my 9. And I've moved the model, so you can have it.
Alright.
Alright, I'll take it.
So, how much... I should... No, fuck it. It's... Yeah, that's it. Okay, that's Widowmaker's done. He's got 13. They've got 13 minutes. Oh, good. Oh, dear. Green models are gonna go. They're gonna activate. I'll do red models. They're just gonna go. Shield wall advance. So 6 inches.
I think Chris has just realized how slow he's been going.
So, it looks like Chris is in an incredibly dominating position in terms of board state. But 13 minutes left. He still may get timed out with all the mechanical recursion.
Two-man C-mat. You're dead.
One solo punch here at mat 6.
You're dead.
One punch there at mat 6.
You're flying.
Do green unit, what is a short wall advance? No.
I mean, I think that is probably Colin's best win condition at this point, is just play quickly. Keep bringing back Mechanothrall, keep his Necrosurgeon safe, and just sit in the zone.
Okay, move to them now. I will put Tax Supremacy for 2.
You get it.
On the green unit. I'm going to take a gunshot at him.
Yep.
Actually, no, you're going to just collect that anyway. I'm going to take a gunshot at that guy.
Yep.
You've got cover.
Yep.
Nope. And I'll count 4.
Okay.
No, I'm just going to die if I do that. I'm going to energize a 3.
Get another soul.
I mean, another problem with the time aspect is every single time Chris has to roll tough, and then if he fails the tough, he has to work out whether he gets a corpse
and
token.
Sitting on 1.
Okay.
Going to go for green unit pikes. I just fucked up. Oh, well.
What did you fuck up?
I moved him out of the way.
Oh,
so
yeah, now you don't have...
I don't have packet. Oh, whatever. Show watch.
Look, all I know is that he should have been playing some more Bone Shakers.
So Chris has just moved Eurus over to the right in order to give the unit of Iron Fang Pikeman on the right attack martial discipline, and then energize it Eurus out of the way in order to
not die and has lost martial discipline.
Quality play there from Chris.
You can see it, like the clock is on his mind. That's right. He made that mistake. He saw his low time, and he's just got that back in the back of his mind now.
And in addition to reducing his camp, he's now given Colin an extra soul as well.
Two-man C-man. Actually, this guy punches... this guy punches that thrall. Kills him.
Oops.
Two-man C-man on the objective.
Yep.
So
it's got 4 damage on it, right?
Yep.
You hit.
So takes 7 damage.
Okay, so it's taking 11.
This guy...
doesn't have line of sight.
This guy punches him. Kills him. And this guy punches the objective for nothing. Blackbane, why are you still alive? this guy, two-man C-mat with this guy leading on Kangas Banks.
Yep. Def 14.
Def 14, miss. And... it's gone. And go!
You're a 15-16 at the moment, 15, right? 15-16. Gatsby gets 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So he has 15?
Shit, I didn't do tax.
I've got to say, though, I've seen Chris play a lot of times, and I've seen him get very low on time and then pull out some amazing victories. So
feet is gone. So 10
minutes
down. We're not going to update it. All right, Bone Shaker Assassination. You don't like me, and I don't like you.
How many Torque Souls do you have?
I have 15 focus.
Wow. All right.
So I can put 3 fully boosteds into you.
Sure.
How much health have you got?
Yeah, 17.
A dice off.
Oh, also I get a control point, which is possibly important.
Average dice, you die. If I hit all 3. Alexia makes it cost double, right? But not if I'm arcing?
Yeah, I feel like the end of that turn was a bit sloppy just because of that time issue. Really could have had a better turn if he'd saved some of that time earlier on in that last turn.
He's a risk is on 1 camp.
3 fully boosted Bone Shakers. Here we go. And potentially he could put the 4th one in, boost the hit roll, but it's not going to be boosted.
There's clock pressure there, I think, getting to Chris.
So essentially, Irisk is just a 15, 16.
I think I have to kill him. I don't think... this is one of those games where I'd like to play out the attrition as well. Like, I kind of don't know which way this goes at this point. It looks like it's in your favor, but I'm about to, I think, kill a whole bunch of shit.
Yeah. I think it would be better if I... I felt like I cocked out. It's such a fucking puzzle, these Crix lists.
They're so complex.
It's like a Rubik's Cube. And if you fail it, the Rubik's Cube bites you. Oh, and sometimes, if you do it improperly, the Rubik's Cube takes pieces of your flesh and makes it into a bigger Rubik's Cube with more angles to solve. That Tax Supremacy is going to cost me. That will cost me. The whole point of it is to tighten the lines. I shouldn't even probably should even put about 4.
3 left. So then I can put 1 more unboosted into you afterwards. I mean, if I roll well, you die. If I don't roll well, you don't die.
I think
that's probably what's going to happen. Do I have any way to put anything else on you? Maybe. Do I have any way to knock you down? I don't think so. Do I have any way to hit you with anything other than my caster's spells?
I mean, what he needs in this list is a file call.
I don't think so. Can I clear enough shit so that Vociferon can actually get to where he has to go?
That is probably going to be an issue. I'd like to hope it's an issue, at least.
You got a laser? So there's the line that we want. The question is, where is...
I think the most amazing thing is that Chris has still only lost, like, 3 pikemen or something total.
I think it's too far away. So I think... Oh, has that guy got a gun? A weapon?
No, he doesn't.
All right. So, then, that way it's there.
Why are you there, retard?
That's pretty close to 8. Just need that one dead, I think.
He's lost a fair amount of pikemen now. I think he's lost about 7 or 8 pikemen. He still has more than half, though.
So if those chicks manage to kill that...
Which is amazing.
They're just in shield wall, they're not in fucking super form.
Yep.
Okay, so we're going to do the Blood Witches first. They're going to get a charge run order. This one is going to charge that model, going out like so.
Yep.
And this one is going to charge the one directly in front of her without moving, basically.
Yep.
This one is going to charge that model to there, mm-hmm. And she's going to run.
So cool, the hag is finally coming into play.
I can measure her command while she's moving, right?
Helping horse there, just popping up with a rules clarification.
The hag then not getting in counter charge range of the dog.
It's the 9 to Rusk.
The interesting thing here is that, of course, it doesn't matter because the Rusk doesn't have pup.
Well, I'm just going to check 6.
No, you're out on that one. Good call, though. Charge attack here. No buff to the mat. Hits. Power 10. Dead.
Yep.
And she'll pop strength onto that guy, which does nothing, but... we'll go charge attack with the... So we'll go her non-charge boosted sword. Yep. She'll hit. Dead.
What's your power?
12.
Yeah, yep.
And we'll go pop strength onto that guy, in case we get lucky. What's your strength?
6.
So that's not going to do it, right? And we'll go here, redirect. She'll miss. Second attack. She'll miss.
The interesting problems okay. Colin has here is he has a list that's really based around abusing Carnage. And, of course, he can't use it
this turn because he needs Asphyxius for the Boneshaker assassination.
Kill that guy.
So he's basically just having to hard roll 7s and 8s here, which is not ideal.
And I could conceivably miss him a lot of times. Is there another place where I can get an Arcanoid that's better?
I think you need to kill one. No, you probably just kill 2 more Black Men. That he's not engaged when he's trying to kill.
He only needs to kill that one.
I'm just going to listen to our voicemail because it might be the angry hotel people we were with.
Because that one is the standard bearer.
I see.
He can use his own models to block line of sight for free strikes because Vociferon's on a small base.
That's true. He could drop in those mechanicals.
This is all a long run to get to that assassination. And I don't know whether or not I'm going to roll it when I get there. But it feels like it's a decent one. Just do it!
Nothing is possible. Just don't do it.
Everything is impossible.
Yesterday, you said yesterday.
You were right. You should have stuck with yesterday. Yep. It's too late now.
Bone Shaker range is 10.
Yep. Yep. Don't. Yeah. Mistakes were made. Oh, mistakes.
Why do you have to make this so difficult?
I don't know. Why do you have to try and kill me with your 7? How do you have 17 focus?
Only 15.
If only 15.
It's fair and balanced.
Of course.
Bone checker range is 8.
8. Yeah, that's so it makes it a lot harder to get Vociferon in a position where he's not engaged.
He walks there, he walks there, he walks there. Do I need that guy dead? I don't think I do. I just need...
Interestingly, after the game, Colin Hill realized that he also had X-Blast, which is range 10, which he had forgotten about.
For the same cost?
For 3 costs.
Yeah, okay. That's an issue, though.
So it's this Necrosurgeon unit. You're going to move 6 that way and get out of the way. You're going to walk forward as far as you possibly can. To there. And poop out 3 Mechanithralls.
Alright.
I suppose he has the three. Three
he's got
spare anyway, yeah.
Now, he can still double boost 3.
Yeah. It just means that he doesn't get possibility of a last unboosted
Aqua
damage roll. Yeah.
It is a mid game. Look at it. 2-0.
It's also 1 extra power.
Been a little bit YOLO.
No,
I had to be. Yeah,
but...
To be honest, this isn't fine. That's a clock. Right, Simon?
So now I need to roll a couple of 8s. So we're going to go with this McThrall unit.
Okay.
This one's going to advance into that guy. This one's going to advance into that guy.
Yeah,
this one's
yeah.
going to advance to block LOS from that guy. So they're right up against you. Doesn't look like you're going to make it, does it?
Might have a trouble with base size, though.
Yeah, he's not going to make it. That's pretty sad.
Yesterday, you said yesterday.
Guy's going to go to there. Guy's going to go to there. Yeah, I'm going for it.
Yes.
Don't have a choice. Gotta do it. Just do it! So the question is, do you kill that guy?
He's blocked line of sight successfully with the small bases there.
So he can run Vociferon now.
Go to there where he's got a line to both of those. And you're gonna walk away.
In
Don't
shame.
Walk away!
Walk away in shame.
Yeah, get the fuck out of the way. Alright, so we'll go first attack here. 7-5.
Needs an 8, rolls a 7.
No. First attack here. No. Second attack here. Yes. Death.
Do I get a roll tough? No, I don't.
No, you do not.
This is shit. I get your... No.
No, you don't. Okay, this guy's going to stab her in the back. He's got her. She'd be dead.
Battle.
No, you don't. All right. First attack here. Miss. Yep. Second attack here. Miss. First attack here. Miss. Second attack here. Miss. First attack here. Miss. Second attack here. Miss. All right.
Okay.
6 non-8s. Excellent.
Awesome.
Well, we've got you in line of sight, so that's okay. So, the question is, can we manufacture a way to kill that one dude? Attempt number 1. Saxon! He's going to shoot that guy.
All right. Need an 8. Ah! 11. Yes, you need an 8.
Failure number 1.
I used 12 minutes so far. Working this out.
One more attempt. Pardon? Yeah, that's 15 focus.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
Right.
But the spell we always laugh at, and of course I'm gonna die, but maybe. someone did say it was the key to the spell list. That someone may have been me and Colin.
That is a lot. I'm not gonna lie, man, it's a lot of bone shakers. The problem is, I don't have any way to clear that one model, and I'm not certain that 8 inches gets me to outside of his range. That's the problem. Arknode has to go there. I don't think... Oh, actually, maybe I'm just fucking retarded, and the Arknode can go somewhere completely different. Yeah, it totally can. Okay, so... In that case... What have we got? 8 minutes? Do we see whether or not we jag that shot just in case it turns out that it solves the problem a different way? Because then we don't need to do that. Alright, Darig. Do I need to use you for a death ride? I might have to. So let's do this guy first. Wait, you've got fucking some spell that makes that guy walk and punch that guy, right?
Bone
Good
shaker?
Job, Ragman.
The same spell you're trying to kill me with?
Yes,
false.
He does actually have that spell.
He's going to bone shaker that guy.
Alright, you do that.
He's going to hit that guy.
Fuck's sake.
going to fail to kill that guy, because fucking just matching armor is what I'm going to do.
Dun dun. Again, he needed one more.
Can't get to that one.
Don't know if I can bone checker.
So we'll do you. We'll get you guys out of the way. We'll pop three mechanithrals that are completely irrelevant to the game. They'll doodle over here, because I just object to not using them.
Value, but
this guy's going to activate. He's going to walk three, and then three to there where he's got a line.
Is Darkfire range 10?
Yep. Okay. And they're going to dirtle.
Alright.
He's going to hit.
Hits.
For God's sake, will you just die? He can't tough. There's a hag right next to him. He can't tough.
He can still drop a Hellfire off Daryl, right?
Yeah, well, I've got to win now. I've got to try to win.
Cankerworm, I don't think I've left you anywhere useful to go. So it's really just down to whether or not I can fit through that fucking gap over there. Or I can try the Hellfire. So I either try the Beyond Death, sorry, the Death Ride. I'm going 12 out to, like, there is where we want to go. I assume he can't arc while he's engaged. If he can, then this whole turn was a complete waste of my time.
If he's engaging, he's fine. If he's engaged, I think
yeah.
Tell me.
He's an arc node.
I need your tap. Sure. Because I'll figure it out. Oh, he's just got the arc node advantage,
yeah,
doesn't he?
That's right.
Okay, yeah, then you, while you're in.
Kangaroo's going to walk the fuck out of the way. And then scuttle even further out of the way.
He's immune to free strikes, right?
Yeah, he is. I don't think there's any other way to get there now other than a Hellfire. Hellfire. Then maybe we kill that guy and we finally get to fucking do this? Alright, fine. Just do it, Darrig. Range 10 Hellfire.
You're in
we
range.
We hitch. Yeah, he's got the 10. There's 10.
Yeah.
14s. Yes! He dies!
I get his corpse.
There you go.
He's done it.
Okay, so that guy's got no weapon.
No. Correct.
Vociferon is going to run. He has no free strike from this guy. He's going to run through this gap. He's going to end facing, so he's not engaging that guy, and he's more than 2 inches from that guy. That's where he's going to be standing.
Sure.
The model is going to be represented by this guy.
All right, Bone Shaker assassination. Here we go. Can he roll it? There's also something else coming up here, which Chris is counting on, and hoping Colin won't notice.
A counter charge or something?
Yeah, with the dog. If he ends in line of sight of the dog, Chris can counter charge the dog into the gap.
Jack?
And block line of sight.
And block line of sight.
I can make my melee range. It's going to really suck if I fail all these bone shakers after this, you know that. Fuck. I see you there, doggy. I need a laser, please.
I was rather hoping you didn't.
He can't see through that model, right?
He cannot.
Colin has noticed the dog.
So he's actually on the move now, Vociferon?
Yeah, he's still moving.
Okay. Do you need me to hold this?
Yeah, please. I need it so that I can line up. You know exactly what I'm trying to do. So. There's the spot, right? I've got line of sight to you. I don't have line of sight to the dog.
And the dog does not, unfortunately. Yeah.
And I'm not engaging either of you.
I'm just going to check the dog doesn't have a bullshit roll that gives me every chance.
Do you want to pause it or not?
Because yeah,
sure. All that's happening now is I'm rolling out three boosted bone shakers.
Ignores Forest Concealment Cover.
Right, so we're going with Gaspy, walk forward.
Just make sure the Sifron's out of the way.
He's not going to walk into your range. He's got the range on the arc node. He's going to boost to hit.
Here we go.
Here it is, folks. This is it. All or nothing. All the marbles. He hits the first one. He boosts the damage.
All right, what's your power?
12.
That's what it's for.
That's 12 damage. He boosts to hit the second one. 8 and 7 is 15. He's got you. He boosts the damage. Come on, Gaspy. Do that shit. I need a piss. I've needed it since turn 2.
That was definitely interesting, setting it up at the end. And he did manage to pull it off, but that was definitely his last ditch. Well played to Colin. Bad luck to Chris.
And thank you to everybody for watching. We've got some more games here on Unplayable Trash, and welcome you all to have a look at them.